It's like it started in year 9, got kicked out on mainstream. Went to a cinema Lewisham with some bad breeds. Some would just turn up late and some would disrupt the class. And some were impossible to teach, except this one girl sitting at the back of the class. Her reading glasses on, he really didn't speak that much. Spent hours in booster lessons, didn't get home till 5:30 sometimes. But still you never heard her stressing. Next day looking fresh with a full smile on her face. Her baby sister keeping her up, sure she's tired all day. Groups of girls are slagging rough on a daily basis. And when school finished, they'll violate and spit in her face. She tried to tell the teacher, but it just made it worse. They got her in the toilets and covered her in cigarette burns. At lunchtime, they put the dirty fingers through her mash. To the point she stormed out, just thinking she was cursed. Her mum prostituting, bringing different men around the house. A mad old boy was trying to pay that rent. And her dad done a runner with 1.5 grand from her mum's savings account when she was only 10. There's no food in the yard, dirty nappies on the floor. Used heroin needles right beside the baby's chair. Social services, they tried to get involved, but there weren't enough evidence, so they put it on hold. A couple months later, she finally got her results. 2 A's of maths and English, plus a major science award. You should have seen her face when she received her applause. But her mum weren't there, so her face soon turned to the floor. So she rang the house phone and said, "Mum, you promised me this, but you let me down again. You're too high in your shit. See, I'm packing my bags, I'm moving out to the sticks to live in Uncle Malcolm's house." Yeah, and that's what she did. She got the quarter past train, bunked all the way, but sitting in the unisex toilet, surrounded with glaze spray, blowing the smoke inside the air vent, drinking from the toilet taps, telling herself she will be okay. Couple hours later, the train finally came to a halt, saying welcome to Norwich as she's counting the dough. She knew she never had enough money to get through the barriers, so she rubbed this old lady's purse on the e-carriage. She got a black cab from outside the station, gave the cabman the address on a scrumpled bit of paper. 10 minutes later, she finally reached her destination, knocked on the door with her mouth dragging, her pulse racing. She ain't seen her uncle in about 10 years, so she's feeling kinda nervous to see what he's saying. But he opens the door with a big smile on his face, with a greeting message, "Oh girl, I ain't seen you in ages." And next thing you know, a couple weeks have passed. Our uncle pulls her at the side and says, "Darling, got a job for ya. I need you to jump on a plane out to Toulouse. Meet a couple of good friends, they'll really treat you good. They'll put you in a 5-star hotel, put 4 grand cash in your hand so you can shop to your job. Live that life for queen, but I need this one thing. I need you to swallow 100 bags just before you leave. See, each cocktail bag contains 12 grams of cocaine, or £16,000 on street value. In the morning you'll get picked up by my good friend Matthew, who'll drop you at the Heathrow Airport at Terminal 2. Plus don't stress yourself, we've done this like 1,000 times, so just follow my lead and you'll be fine." CJ was quite gullible, plus she looked up to her uncle, so when they dropped the merch she couldn't decline. The morning soon came around, she started shitting herself. With the cocktails in the system, she hit the airport around 11:45, hit the check in desk 10 minutes late, not feeling too great but still pushing herself. Then out of the blue she got this mad pain in her left hand. She started breathing heavy, then collapsed. See, the coat unwrapped properly, erupted in the stomach, and her body couldn't function. And now she's playing Pirates with Edward Fetch. Shit.